please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
The big corporate story that was out this morning was Bharti Infratel and Indus Tower announcing the merger. My colleague Nisha is here in the studios. She's been reporting on this deal now for the last year or so, actually. It's been that long in the making, actually. But it's finally out. So, Nisha, first to you. Done and dusted?
Oh, yes. It's been 2 years since the time Bharti Airtel started to think about selling stake and monetizing stake in Bharti Infratel. So it's been 2 years that we've been trying to really take stock of this particular large transaction. And it had to take so much time because there were big telecom players like Vodafone, Idea, Bharti Airtel, all to come to one table for one deal was an extremely difficult task. But kudos to them that finally it is done, also because of the pressures that they're seeing in the telecom sector. To take you through the contours of the deal that has been announced, which we remember reported first, is that Bharti Infratel and Indus Tower will merge to create the largest telecom tower company in the listed space in the country. And this will have a valuation, an equity valuation of $14.6 billion. Now, we know that Idea Cellular as well as Providence are also stakeholders in Indus Tower. So what will happen is that Idea as well as Providence will get the option to exit or stay on with the merged entity. Apart from that, if Idea exits, Bharti Airtel and Vodafone are going to be the joint promoters of the merged large entity, with Bharti Airtel getting 37.2% stake and Vodafone 29.4% stake. For Idea, it could be a good gain because it is $1 billion for their 11% stake in Indus Tower that they can get at a time when they will be very heavily debt-laden while the merger with Vodafone is going on. Apart from that, the merger ratio is 1,565 shares of Bharti Infratel for one share of Indus. So it is going to be a large company being created. And of course, they can monetize, Bharti Airtel can monetize their stake going forward in order to really pump in more money and build war chest for the telecom business.
Reema is standing by as well. Reema, morning. I mean, for existing shareholders, what will this transaction mean?
They now have a presence. They're getting in Indus as well. It creates a pan-India presence. So, you're getting a pan-India player. So, for existing shareholders, it's a little more of the same. I don't think people have any qualms with the valuations given to Infratel as well as Indus, at least not up until now. So, I guess it's more of the same. Today, Infratel is under pressure is on account of the financial challenges faced by the tower companies itself. In the conference call yesterday, they indicated that already we've lost tenancies. The co-locations were down 22,000 in FY18, and going ahead with the Idea Vodafone merger coming on board, the gross tenancies could be impacted to the tune of 25,000. That will be over a period of 2 to 3 years, the time it takes to consolidate. So people, the shareholders of tower companies right now are more worried about, the weakness of the operators and what that will mean in terms of, the impact on tower companies.
Reema, the other story, of course, has also been Bharti, right? I mean, the results. What is the one big highlight? The buoyancy in data consumption?
Yes, so that is a big positive. So just quickly, let me run you through the numbers. For one, slightly better than expectations. People thought there would be a loss, but they managed to report a profit. The beat at the operational level was led by Africa. India margins continue to see sequential pressure. At the EBIT level, there was a loss to the tune of 482 crore. The average revenue per user on expected lines has declined by nearly 6% on a quarter-on-quarter basis. But it's the internal metrics which look good. A lot of the other telecom players are also bleeding financially, but they're not managing to report such strong internal metrics, which is what has buoyed the streets. Whether it's the volume growth on voice or the data volume growth of 40% on a year-on-year basis, the minutes of usage have gone up by 15 to 20% on a quarter-on-quarter basis. So all these metrics are looking good. The other key reason why Bharti is higher in trade is because of the TDSAT ruling, which provides at least interim relief. Remember, the TRAI had tweaked the definition of a significant market player when it was calculating whether an operator was using predatory pricing. That has been put on hold for now, so that comes as a relief for telecom players. And finally, it's the merger with Indus, because now Bharti Airtel can monetize its stake in a much larger entity and, get some money in from perhaps PE players. And the stock was, of course, down 20% in 2018 itself, so it's already gotten hit quite a bit.